Starting hands and knees, tabletop position, making sure that your knees are in line with your hips and your wrists are in line with your shoulders. We'll just take a few rounds of cat and cow. So on your next exhale, start to arch through your back, bringing your chin toward your chest. Inhale, sink your belly down as you gaze up. Exhale, arch through your back, chin towards your chest. Inhale, sink the belly down. And just continue to move here with your breath, nice and easy. Last round. And on your exhale, come back to tabletop position. Engage your belly button toward your spine and reach your right leg back behind, flexing through your right foot. Really extend out through that right heel. Stay there or extend your left arm out in front. Extend out through the fingertips and the heel, lengthening. And on your next exhale, bring your elbow and your knee toward each other. Inhale, extend. Exhale, elbow and knee. Inhale, extend one more time. Exhale, elbow and knee. Inhale, extend. Pause here. And then on your next exhale, open the arm and leg out to the diagonal so that you feel your right obliques or those side abdominal muscles engage. Inhale, come back to the center. Exhale, place the hand in the knee. Regrouping. When you're ready, extend your left leg back behind, flexing through the foot. Belly button working toward your spine. Reach your right arm. Extend out through the fingertips and the heel. And on your exhale, bend your elbow toward your knee. Inhale, extend. Exhale, elbow and knee. Inhale, extend. One more time. Exhale, elbow and knee. Inhale, extend. Reaching. And then on your next exhale, open the arm and the leg out to the diagonal. Feeling those left obliques engage. Inhale, come back to the center. Exhale, place the hand and the knee. Curl your toes under. Start to cross your toes into the earth. Really spread through your fingers. And then lift your knees just about an inch above the mat. Engaging the core. Option to stay here. Otherwise, on your inhale, you're going to take a hovering cow pose. Exhale, arch through the back. Inhale, hovering cow. Exhale, hovering cat. One more time each way. And come back to tabletop. On your exhale, cross your hips up and back, downward facing dog. And just take a few breaths here to walk your dog. Just alternating, bending one knee, straightening the other. And come up high onto your toes. Press your hips up toward the ceiling. Melt your heart, gazing toward your knees. On your exhale, gently lower the heels down, spreading through the fingers. Inhale, reach your right leg up behind. Exhale, bend your knee toward your nose. Inhale, sweep the leg back behind. Exhale, knee to nose. Inhale, leg back behind. Exhale, knee to nose. Really scoop up in your belly. Step the foot in between your hands. Left knee comes down, top of the left foot comes down. And inhale, reach the arms up. Reaching the frontal hip points forward and slightly up. Tailbone down, modified lunge. Anjaneyasana. On your exhale, plant your left hand down in line with the toes. Reach your right arm up and come into a twist here. And stay here or reach the right arm back. Maybe bend that left knee, touch the foot with the hand. I'm getting a nice quadricep stretch here. Opening up through the front of that left hip crease. Gently release that foot, reach the right arm up. Exhale, place the right hand to the outside of the foot, pick the back knee up, step back to plank, top of a push-up. Pause here. Really press the mat away with your palms. Press the mat away with your toes. And on your exhale, hips up and back. Downward facing dog. Inhale, your left leg up behind. Exhale, bend your knee toward your nose. Inhale, kick the leg back behind. Exhale, knee to nose. Inhale, kick that leg back behind. Exhale, knee to nose, scoop up in the belly, step the foot in between the hands. Right knee comes down, top of the right foot comes down, and inhale the arms up, reaching those frontal point, hip points forward, tailbone down. Exhale, bring the right hand down in line with the toes, reach that left arm up, coming into a twist here. Reach the left hand back, maybe bend that right knee, catch the foot with your hand. If you have a strap, you can always hook the strap around the foot to help you gain more leverage there. Gently release the toes down, reach the left arm up. Exhale, place the left hand, pick the back knee up, step back to plank. Pausing here, building a little bit of heat in the body, engaging through the core, press the mat away. On your exhale, keeping the elbows as straight as you can without locking them out. So you want to make sure there's a slight bend there. Start to sink your chest down, allowing the shoulder blades to come away from the back. Inhale, come back up to regular plank. Exhale, sink the chest down. Good. Inhale, come back up. Exhale, sink the chest down. Inhale, come back up to plank. Exhale, downward facing dog. So just getting a little bit of movement there in the scapula. And just kind of switching it up. We're so used to holding the shoulder blades onto the back in plank pose. So just getting that extra little bit of strength building there. Inhale, bend your knees, look forward. Step or lightly hop toward the front part of the mat. Exhale, fold here. Inhale, root down through the feet. Sweep your arms out and up. And exhale, palms come down to heart center. Making sure that your feet are parallel. Maybe the big toes are touching. Heels are slightly apart. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Reach up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, your heart forward. Hands come to your shins or out underneath the shoulders. Exhale, fold. Putting a slight bend in the knees, step the feet back, plank pose. We're gonna take those little scapula push-ups there. So start to sink the chest down. Inhale, come back up. Exhale, moving the scapula away from the back. Inhale, come back up. Last one. Good, inhale, regular plank. And press the hips up and back, downward facing dog. Inhale, your right leg up behind. And on your exhale, bend your knee toward your nose. Inhale, kick the leg up behind. Exhale, knee toward right elbow. Inhale, kick the leg back behind. Exhale, knee toward left elbow. Pause here. Extend that leg out to the side, staying here. Or gently start to bring the hips down, bending the elbows. Chest comes down. Reach your arms out to the sides. Maybe even turn your gaze toward that right hand. Coming into Bridges Cross. Getting a nice stretch through the outer leg. And stretching through the IT band area. This is great for runners or any kind of athletes where you're running a lot. Bend the elbows. Turn the head back to the center. Press into the hands, lift the hips up, bend the knee in toward the nose, step your foot in between your hands. Option to bring that back knee down. Inhale, come up for crescent lunge. Put a slight bend in that back knee if you feel any pulling on the low back. Bend into the front knee, reaching the tailbone down. Good. On your exhale, palms come together and down to heart center. Inhale here, and on your exhale, twist. Bring your left elbow to the outside of that right knee. Gazing up over the right shoulder. Make your back leg nice and strong. Inhale, bring the chest back to the center. Exhale, place the hands, step back to plank. And taking those little scapular push-ups, sink the chest down. Inhale, come back up. Exhale, down. Inhale, back up. Last one. Exhale, down. Inhale, up. Exhale, press back to downward facing dog. Inhale your left leg up behind. Exhale, knee toward your nose. Inhale, kick the leg back behind. Knee toward left elbow. Inhale, three-legged dog. Exhale, knee toward right elbow. Extend the leg out to the side. Stay here or start to bend the elbows. Lower the hips down. Chest comes down. Reach to the sides. Maybe turn your gaze toward those left fingers. And inhale, bring your head back to the center, bend the elbows, placing the palms underneath the shoulders, press up, bend the knee in toward the chest, step the foot in between the hands, good. Making sure that you're nice and stable, make that back leg nice and strong, inhale the arms up, cross and lunge, frontal hip points working forward, tailbone down, exhale, palms come together and down to heart center, inhale here, on your exhale, twist, bringing that right elbow to the outside of the left knee. Make your right leg nice and strong. Inhale, come back to the center. Exhale, place the hands, step back to plank. One more time with those scapular push-ups, sink the chest down. Inhale, up. Exhale, down. Inhale, up. Exhale, down. And these are always optional. You can always just stay in plank pose. Exhale, cross your hips up and back. Downward facing dog. Inhale, bend your knees, look forward. Step or lightly hop toward the front of the mat. Exhale, fold. Inhale, root down as you rise up. Exhale, palms come down to heart center. On your inhale, bring your weight onto your left leg. Bend your right knee out in front. Really use those low abs and the hip flexors to help pull that leg up. Feeling nice and steady here. On your next exhale, start to lean the torso forward as you kick that right leg back. Warrior three, keep the foot flexed. Extend out through the heel and the crown of the head. Start to bend into that left knee. Reach the right toes down and inhale the arms up. Crescent lunge. On your exhale, palms come together and down to heart center. And twist, bringing your right elbow to the outside of that left knee. And making that right leg nice and strong. Inhale, bring the torso back to the center. Start to lean forward and then pick up that back leg, warrior three. Good, inhale. Bringing that right knee out in front. Start to bend that standing leg and cross your right ankle over the left knee. Sitting back into balanced chair. Staying here or maybe leaning forward. Maybe placing the fingertips on the earth. Inhale, come back up. And on your exhale, gently come back to standing. And switching sides, bring your weight onto your right foot, left knee comes out in front. Really try to raise that left knee up using the low abs, engaging through the core. Start to bring the torso forward as you kick that leg back behind warrior three. Start to bend into that right leg, reaching the left toes down. Press and lunge, bringing the palms together, back down to heart center. On your exhale, twist, bring that left elbow to the outside of the right knee. Inhale, bring the torso back to the center, start to lean forward, picking up that back leg, warrior three. Inhale, bend the knee out in front. Start to bend that right knee as you stack the left ankle over the top of that right knee. Come into that balanced chair, stay here, or bring the fingertips down to the earth, deepening that stretch through the outer left hip. Inhale, bring the hands back to the center, gently come back to standing. And then on your next inhale, start to walk the feet out so that they're hip distance apart. Turn the toes out.
On your exhale, start to bend the knees as you bring your tailbone down, coming into Malasana or Garland pose. Triceps or outer parts of the arms come up against the inner knees. Pausing here, pressing the chest forward. And then you can stay here, otherwise plant your hands and come into crow pose, bakasana. Walking the knees up toward the armpits and then picking up one foot and maybe the other. Good, exhale, jump back. Come into chaturanga. Inhale, cobra or upward dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Good. On your inhale, bend your knees, look forward, and either step the feet behind the hands or lightly hop. Turning the toes out, sink the hips down. Come back into Malasana, Garland pose. We're gonna take that crow pose one more time if you'd like. Bring the hands down, picking the hips up, walking the knees toward the armpits. Lean forward. And then pick those feet up. And you can bring the feet down and lightly step back to chaturanga or hop up. Inhale, cobra or upward dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Taking about five breaths here. Really reaching the hips up toward the ceiling, melting your heart. Taking a nice deep exhale out of the mouth. Releasing the heat. On your inhale, bend your knees, look forward, step or lightly hop toward the front part of the mat. Exhale, folding here. Inhale, sweep the arms out and up. And exhale, palms come down to heart center. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Reach the arms up, come up onto your toes. Really hug the inner thighs, inner feet toward each other. Pull the belly button toward the spine. Gazing forward. On your exhale, start to bend the knees. So if you have knee issues, just come straight to sitting. That's where we're going. And keep lowering down until you come into a vertical squat. Good. Reaching the arms out in front. Start to lean forward as you bring your heels down, hips down, and come right up into Navasana boat pose. Knees can be bent or more straight. Soften the shoulders. Good, exhale, bring the feet down. Extend the left leg out in front. Bend that right knee in toward your chest. Sit up nice and tall. Reach your right hand back behind. Inhale that left arm up. And on your exhale, twist, bringing the left elbow to the outside of the right knee. Gazing out to the side or over the back shoulder. And coming into this sage twist here. I'm just watching the shoulders, making sure that they're in line with the hips instead of leaning way back into that back hand. Inhale, bring your head back to the center. Exhale, gently unwind. Drop that right knee out to the side. Inhale, the arms up. And on your exhale, fold forward over that extended leg. Releasing through your head and your neck. Allowing a slight rounding through the upper back. Really just melt into this pose. Inhale, gently lift the gaze. Bring the torso back up. Extend the right leg. Bend the left knee in toward your chest. Sit up nice and tall. Reach the left hand back behind. Inhale, the right arm up. And on your exhale, twist. Gazing out to the side or over the left shoulder. And allowing that right elbow up against the knee to help facilitate the twist. Inhale, bring your head back to the center. Exhale, gently unwind. Left knee drops out to the side. Inhale, the right, or both arms up. And exhale, fold over that right leg. Releasing the upper body, allowing it to melt over that right leg. Inhale, gently lift the gaze, release the foot, and extend the left leg. Reaching the arms out in front, you can also have your knees bent. Start to pull your belly button in toward your spine. And on your exhale, gently start to lower back with control, engaging through the core. Lowering all the way down. Bend the knees so that they're close to your hips. Bending your elbows so your fingertips are pointing up toward the ceiling. On your inhale, start to press into your feet and your upper arm bones as you lift your hips up, coming into Setubandha or Bridge Pose. Stay here or extend the fingers, reaching the hands for the feet, or roll the shoulders under. Really press the backs or the sides of the hands into the earth so that your biceps are reaching up toward the ceiling. Reach the hips up. Exhale, gently lower down with control. Once your hips are down, walk the feet out to the sides an inch or two. Drop the knees together. Coming into constructive rest, you can rest your hands on your belly. Just allow the muscles through the low back to release. And on your inhale, gently walk the feet back in line with the hips. Cross your right leg over the top of your left leg. Reach the arms out into a T. And on your exhale, release your knees over to the left. Coming into a reclining twist here, supine twist. Soften that right shoulder down. Inhale, come back to the center, unwind the legs, cross the left leg over the top of that right leg, and then release the knees over to the right. Inhale, bring the knees back to the center, uncrossing the legs. Walk the soles of the feet together. Allow the knees to drop out to the sides. You can leave the arms as they are, or you can rest the hands on the belly and come into reclining bound angle pose or Supta Baddha Konasana. Closing your eyes or softening your gaze. Just taking a few moments to come to your breath. Bringing your gaze inward. Resting the whole body. And stay as long as you like. And thank you for practicing with me. Namaste.